There are many household sayings that bother in a certain way when you are working on, say, an electronic circuit. And this is one of them that I'm working on. It's a microphone amplifier. Well, to get as low noise as possible. And I will publish it when it's ready. But in the meantime, I found, for instance, that this thing, don't know the exact word, you can light the gas with it, so it's a kind of gas lighter. Didn't work properly. The sparks between here, this point, and I found out that it is a kind of spring, very strange, but anyway. And there's a hood of tin plate that covers this in this way. And there is also, perhaps not visible here, a kind of copper wire connected to that hood. And when you press the button here, you have a spark that ignites the gas. Anyway, it works, of course, but it didn't work very good, so I'm cleaning it. That's the first thing to do in such a case. There was oxidation here inside. And also, well, oxidation is the most important part. That oxidation is, of course, also caused by the spark. Say an electric spark also always makes an oxidation point at the point where the spark reaches the metal or whatever. So perhaps I'm can make this apparatus work again. I hope so. If not, I will throw it away anyway. But the whole thing is interesting because we have here inside a crystal or a kind of ceramic material that, when it is exposed to, say, a mechanical shock, it gives out a voltage. And that's not very strange. In electronics and in radio circuits, we see this very often. And this is the, say, the principle. A mechanical force is applied to a crystal, and that's called a piezo element. Often that's called that way, but the whole idea goes much further. And when that mechanical force is applied to that crystal, we have here a kind of spark. That doesn't have to be a spark, by the way. Only in this case, in this cooking apparatus, it creates a spark to ignite the gas. But the whole principle is more general. We can also find this principle where, when a crystal bends or is bended, a voltage is generated parallel to the plates that are, say, mounted to that crystal. And here are some examples. A phono pickup cartridges from the old ages, where we had vinyl records. I want to show that mechanical force means that the thing can work as a detector. So here you see, for instance, a crystal headphone. You can hear, there's a thing here that in such a way that you can put it into your ear. And here a voltage can be applied, that can be everything, an audio signal or whatever. And the good thing of this crystal headphone is that it is extremely sensitive. So when you do radio experiments, first experiments with radios, etc., the crystal headphone is a kind of ideal earphone to use because it is so extremely sensitive. On the other hand, it also has an extremely high impedance. So to get it working, sometimes you need a resistor here. A resistor parallel to which the voltage falls. The voltage of the radio signal falls. Anyway, I told that you can also say reverse this effect. And that's used in radio technology when you have, for instance, a crystal oscillator. Here is a crystal. You can see it clearly inside. Beautiful crystal, two plates here. And to each plate there is an electrode. And it's a double oscillator crystal for 455 kHz. A ceramic pickup coil. It can be used for to playback vinyl records, and my camera tells me that I have to stop anyway. And also here a delay line. Inside that delay line of an old school television set, there is a ceramic part or a crystal that gives certain delay when a signal is put at the input and read out at the output. I cannot tell much more because my camera indicates that I have to stop anyway. It's all about, say, effects of force on a crystal, crystal effects, and here the practical use of that effect. So, repairing this this thing it gave me some inspiration to make this video. And there is much more on the World Wide Web about the so-called piezo electric effect, piezoelectric effect.